They do anything for clout. Anything. Do anything for clout.
Whole lot of people need to hear this. It's a lot of names on my hit list.
Okay, like, this is so hectic. I feel like you'll be up in the club and the chick like passes and you're like a pack. But when we try to retaliate and do the same thing, ha! It's I'm telling y'all, like, some of these things, I was like, yo, okay, cool, hectic. But yeah, so I'm gonna be telling you guys the answers, and here we go. Y'all, welcome back. We are back. We're back in business. You know what I'm saying? I took a break yesterday, but this is because I had a surprise for y'all. You know, me and a lovely group of ladies got together and did the Don't Rush Challenge. My Zim girls, you know what I'm saying? So if you guys haven't already watched that, please go to my Instagram or my Twitter. The handle is the same, Nabby107, and make sure you watch that because it was lit. I mean, We look good. That's all I'm saying. We look super good. And I think we represented the nation well. So yeah, make sure you check that out. But anyway, for today's video, I asked a few questions to the ladies and the guys. And, you know, I'm going to be revealing the answers to you guys. And I'll also be giving you guys my opinion on whatever the person's saying. So the first question was, I mean, things guys do that girls don't. What? Oh gosh. Things guys hate that girls do, okay? And the first response I got was doubt themselves. Guys, I'm telling y'all, it's a cold world out there. Like, at some point in time, you're gonna doubt yourself, but then you raise up and you're like, oh my gosh, I'm a queen. Excuse me. Make way, please, please. I am passing. Make way, you know? But I feel like we all have that time where we're all feeling like, oh my gosh, I'm not so pretty. This person's prettier than me. And they're doing so much better than me, whatever. And then you start doubting yourself. You're like, what am I doing wrong? What should I do? And, you know, all these things. And it's just part of growing up, guys. I can't tell you that I don't know if there's actually a person who has never doubted themselves in their lives. Like, that is crazy. I would actually give you so much respect, but at the same time, I think it helps you grow. So, you know, it's a process. Growth is a process, guys. The next answer was arguing. Guys, hey! I don't know why guys feel like it's only girls that like to argue. I mean, I have interacted with guys that love to argue. Literally everything you say, this thing is bashing you, and you're like, bruh. What the hell? I am trying to have a normal conversation with you. Like, I don't understand. But anyway, so arguing. I mean, we get bored, okay? We get bored sometimes. And we're just like, you know what? Let's start a fight. And it's honestly sometimes like something so stupid. And it just becomes like a hobby. I actually don't have the energy. I really don't. The next answer was jumping into conclusions. Y'all lead us there. Let me tell you, you guys literally push us. You're like, "Hua," and then you blame us for jumping into conclusions. I mean, what are we supposed to think when you're acting out? You know what I'm saying? So, Vela, if you don't want us to jump, you must not lead us there. You must not push us. Don't push us. That's all I'm saying. Like, don't push us. If you don't push us, we don't jump. Simple. Simple, simple, simple. I don't understand. But anyway, maybe I'm being defensive. Sometimes we do jump into conclusions, but also you guys are not clear. Like, be clear with us, be open with us. And I'm pretty sure these things would be happening like way less, you know? So yeah, sometimes you'll force us, hey, no lies. The next answer is wearing wigs. Like, who are you? Anyway, I really, I'm not gonna dignify that with like a response, really. Like, that's so, what the hell? No ways. Decide where y'all wanna go eat. God damn it. You know what? That's actually kind of, it's a hard question, guys. It's a hard question. Cause sometimes you don't know what you want. Girls are generally like very confused human beings. Let me tell you that now. And sometimes you just don't know what you want to eat at that time. And someone's like pressurizing you and asking you, what do you want to eat? What do you want to eat? So please, like, If you want to get us food, just say, we are going to. Don't be asking me all these questions now, like, oh my gosh, now I have pressure. Now I'm thinking, okay, maybe we overthink things. I'm thinking, okay, what do I really want to eat? Okay, what if I'm, like, trying to be considerate? What if I really like expensive food and, you know, and I don't know how your pocket is looking at that time? And now, when you ask me and I say this place, you're going to be like, yo, this hun was eating my money. And you know all the shit that guys say after, like, you'll have, like, a little bed episode or whatever. You're like, bruh, but you ask me what you want to eat. Or then you start judging my taste. Like, you know, if we're cool, if we're like super cool and we've reached that level where you're like, yeah, no bruh, like we eat whatever we eat, it's cool. But like, if I don't know you and now you're asking me, where do you want to eat? First of all, I'm thinking you're going to judge by taste. You're going to judge what I'm going to eat. So I need to be wise about it. I need to like properly think about it. So y'all need to give us time, okay? You need to give us time to think. Thank you very much. Next answer. Friend zoning. Sometimes you're just better off as friends. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's times when you just know, guys, that, okay, this person's cool, but, like, they're cool. We can be cool. We can be besties. We can go out. Like, we can do all these things, but, like, it's going to be nothing more. And you can't really blame a person for, like, friend zoning you because maybe you're just not their preference. You're not their type. And that's totally okay. I feel like that's something that you have to accept when you're, like, yeah, at our age now. So, you know what? It happens. And the last answer that I'm going to respond to was ghosting. Guys, when it's done, it is a done. Like, there is no turning back. Sometimes, you know what, I know it's not healthy. I know it's not healthy to ghost people, especially when you, like, actually created some sort of relationship with them and whatever. But you know what? Like, sometimes a person just doesn't want your energy anymore and they don't know how to tell you. So they're like, you know what? It's better I just, like, run away literally from this person than to hurt them. And I feel like sometimes it's actually being considerate in that sense. That was basically the guy section. Now I move on to the girl section. Yo, we're never ready. But anyway, number one. Thinking their opinion is always valid. Yo, guys, why? Why do you do this? Like, I really don't understand. Why do you do that? Everyone is entitled to their own opinion. It's basically a right. And you guys just think you're right all the time. Like, no, stop it. Stop it. And, you know, you need to look at it from my side, whatever, whatever. Like, stop. You know, listen. Listen. Okay? The next answer is never answering questions. Yo, people are actually so fucking annoying. Like, sorry for swearing, but some of y'all are so annoying. Like, my gosh, you can't answer a simple question. A simple question. Guys, this guy will literally go like this. Gone, gone, gone. Like, anything to avoid this question, he will answer like all the other questions in the back there, whatever, trying to make it make sense. And now you're trying to connect the dots, jump into conclusions because y'all niggas made us. And you know, that's literally how it happens. Like, some of y'all just don't know how to answer plain and simple questions. It's so like, it's tiring, guys. It's so tiring, honestly. Like, stop. You need to change. You need to change your ways. Anyway, the next one is they just think we are always on our periods all the time. What? Okay, no. I'll actually say the opposite for some reason. Like, I don't know. Is this like a general feeling that ladies get? Because I haven't gotten this yet. So yeah, if you guys do get that a lot, if people think that you're on your periods a lot, maybe you're just moody. Maybe you're just like a moody person and they automatically think, oh shit, this it's that time of the month, this hand is tripping. Like, you know, no, I haven't gotten this before. The next answer is a lying. You guys are serial liars. Yo ha. Okay, not all of you, I won't say all of you, but like, ha, some of y'all can lie. Some of y'all, some of y'all need awards, man. That's all I'm saying. Some of y'all deserve awards. You guys deserve recognition because y'all can lie. You guys, oh my gosh. Let's not get into it. Like, I can't. The last one is, okay, the second last actually, they don't put in effort in their style. It depends with the kind of guys that you're dealing with, first of all. Some niggas actually be out there trying to look good, like, all the damn time. And then you be like, yo, bruh, like, you're making me look bad. What the hell's up with that, you know? So it depends with the people that you interact with, guys. If you want to look good, talk to people who look good. Talk to people who are doing what you want to be doing in your life, you know? You actually have choice, guys. People are not forced into your life. No. That is not true. You actually can go out and talk to people and connect with people that are on your level and attract people that are on your level, be it style, be it humor, you know? That's what I'm going to say. The last one is communication, exclamation marks. Whoa! Yes, I totally agree. Like, y'all niggas act like you just learned how to use a phone 2 days ago. Like, what the fuck? But, man. Communication's a real thing, hey? Like, for any relationship to work, you need to communicate. And I feel like most of y'all just don't know how to. I don't know how that happened. I don't know how y'all were made in your brains. You're like, no, if I say what's up in the morning and I reply the next day, it's all good, like, whatever. And I get it, like, I get that you're busy, or you are spending some alone time, some personal time, blah 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 blah, all those things. But, like, at least say it. At least say that you're busy. Say that you went somewhere. Say that you're doing this. You know, us girls are, like, very good at communicating. And once we see that this nigga's not communicating, we're just like, bruh, I mean, you did this to yourself. Now we're both not communicating. And now shit is going south. Shit is going, like, ooh, done. What would you guys like to ask girls but think it's a bit rude or inappropriate, okay? And the first answer, this cracked me up so much, like, what the hell. This is a bit inappropriate, sorry, but it was, what is their size so we can get the right thing when they ask us to go buy, like, menstrual thingies for them or whatever. I don't know how to answer this. I don't know how to answer this for you. I feel like for pads, it depends, like, you know, there are different types of pads. So if it's your girl, then, or you guys are tight like that, just ask the damn person, like, yo, what pads do you use? Simple, like, don't beat around the bush and be like, oh, but there's this and there's that, and no, we're already irritated, we're already in pain, we're already having cramps. So don't ask those questions. And then when it's like tampons, obviously you have to ask. I mean, there's like two. So you need to ask. You need to ask your girl, like, bruh, what is the size? You know what I'm saying? Like, it's really not that inappropriate. The next one is, set me up with your friend without sounding like you're not attractive. Ooh. Okay, this one, it depends who it is, honestly. If I had a crush on you, or I had a crush on you, or we used to talk before, and then like talk like that, and then you come up to my ass and be like, yo, set me up with this person, I'm like, bye. Like, bye. But if you're like a totally new person, I don't think that's too much of a problem. And yeah, if we haven't had any history, then that shouldn't be hectic. It's fine. You can be like, yo, you're like, you guys are super good looking and whatever, but I'm eyeing your friend over there. Like, can you do something for me? And that can work out. I also think it depends with how you say it. So yeah, just be nice about it. Don't come up to me and just be like, oh, I want your friend. Like, sis, man, bye. So yeah. The third one, why do you bleach your skin? How? Wah. Guys, I feel like this has been asked to so many people, so many celebrities, and has been answered like so many times. I feel like it's all about the beauty standards in the world and fitting in and all these things, like all these things that you've grown up with as a black woman, not even as just a black woman, like even Indian chicks like bleach their skin because the more fair girls are attractive or whatever. Like, I've seen, you know what, Black Girl Magic has been booming. It has been rising. Thank you very much, you know, for everyone who has made it happen, from Beyonce to like the whole world. But I am telling you, this is only online, okay? In the real world, that shit don't exist. That shit is like, yeah, you're black and you're pretty, but ooh, look at her, you know? So I feel like it's just beauty standards, like all over again. That's just how it goes. And then we also asked the girls the same question, what do you want to ask the guys? And the first one was, why can't men try to be more open with us? I agree. You guys act like when we don't tell you shit, you're like, oh my gosh, she's hiding shit from me. But yo, if you know, guys will literally tell you this much about themselves, or be this open about themselves. The rest of the things you don't know. You don't even know what the hell's happening in his brain half the time, or like, yeah, what is happening in his life in general. You don't know. And I guess it all comes down to like toxic masculinity and how it's been this whole big boys don't cry, or black men, yeah, whatever, all those things that you grew up with as a man. So I feel like real men cry, and you know, they actually open up to people, like talk about their emotions and stuff like that. So yeah, it's one of those things. I really hope that, you know, people can stop being real. Just stop being real with us, y'all. And then this, oh gosh, people are crazy. Why do guys not like their bums touched? Ah, jeez, this is hectic, eh? Like, this is so hectic. I feel like you'll be up in the club and the chick like passes and you're like a pat. But when we try to retaliate and do the same thing, ha! It's like you just I don't know, you sinned the biggest sin in the world, you know? Like, that is some crazy ass shit. That's literally how it happens. So yeah, I feel like that's so funny. And you guys, maybe it has like that whole jail thing to it, whatever. You guys tell us, because we really don't know. Like, we don't understand why it's like the biggest hoo-ha in the world. So yeah, please, if someone can respond to that. Why do some guys lie that they are allergic to deodorant? Oh my gosh, guys, like, you need to smell good. For you, okay, you can be as good looking and attractive, like all the right things in the right places, but if you don't smell good, ha, I'm telling you, your attraction levels literally go down the drain like this. You need to smell good. I don't know, like, if you're actually like being genuine and you're allergic to deodorant, then find something else that's gonna make you smell good, okay? Because we don't want to be smelling all that nasty shit, like, no. So yeah, that was basically it for the questions, guys. And yeah, I had a lot of fun, like, just thinking about what people are, like, saying and what's going on through their minds. You know, it was crazy. It was funny. But yeah, if you guys, like, you guys tell me what you think about what I think and what you think about what other people think, you know, like, comment down below and let me know what's happening. But yeah, that's basically it for today, guys. I am gonna go. Don't forget to check out the challenge. I'm telling you, it'll be worth watching. And yeah, it's been good. It's been great. Like, comment, and subscribe. Your girl is out. Oh, and I might as well come out of this a makeup artist, because y'all can see how the girl's looking. Anyway.